Hi, and welcome to another Shotcut tutorial. A few months ago, I posted a video explaining how to export a specific part of the timeline. But thanks to timeline markers that were added to Shotcut at the end of October 2021, now there is a much easier and faster way to do it. In the middle of a long project, suppose I just added a transition between two video clips and also a text clip on the track above. Each video clip have filters to enhance the colors. I also added a 360 degrees filter to the text clip to give it this curved effect, and there are keyframes to make the text move from right to left. I'm using my older computer to record this part of the tutorial, and as you can see, even if I only try to move the playhead from one frame to another, it takes a lot of time to update the view. Needless to say, if I tried to play the video in Shotcut right now, it would be extremely laggy. In these conditions, the only way for me to get an accurate preview of this part of the timeline is to export it. And I will use a marker to do it. The first step is to place a marker a few frames before the start of the transition. Move the playhead at the position where you want to create the marker, and click the marker button in the timeline toolbar. You can also press the M key on your keyboard. A marker can be used to point to a single frame in the timeline. But it can also be extended to cover a range of multiple frames. For example, if you need to extend a marker to the right, position your mouse cursor on the right side of a marker, press and hold the Control key, then left-click and drag that half of the marker to the right. Use the same method to extend it to the left, but grab and drag the left side instead. By the way, when it is extended like this, a marker is called a range. Extend the marker over the area you want to export. Go to the export panel. In the From menu, select your marker in the list. If you have more than one range marker in your project, make sure you select the right one. Hovering the mouse cursor on the markers will display their names. If you are satisfied with the other export settings, click the export button and choose a location to save the video file. Exporting such a short video, 5 seconds in this case, should only take a few seconds to a couple of minutes, depending on your computer. In no time, you can watch an accurate preview of your latest edits. Like this one. Thank you for watching. I hope this video was useful to you. If you want to help the channel, please take a couple of seconds to hit the like and subscribe buttons, and to activate the notification bell. I hope to see you again soon in my next tutorial.